Hello and welcome to Midweek Meditations, where we have the opportunity to share with you what God has shared with us. Been locked into this powerful series called This Is All of Us. We've been taking a look at the family, a look from a biblical perspective to where we are right now. And this past weekend, man, we talked about Genesis, the 38th chapter. We looked at this young lady named Tamar and her interaction with two of Judah's sons. Judah, who is the brother of Joseph, had two sons. As a matter of fact, he had three, but two of his sons, his first two sons, he gave to Tamar to marry. Oh, the first one, the Bible says, was wicked. Heir was wicked, and the Lord had to kill him. And then the second one, the father said, I need you to marry Tamar and bring a child out of that relationship. And we found that Onan did not do what his father, he didn't do everything that his father told him to do. He did get with her, but he didn't want to bring a child out of that situation. And so we brought out three quick points from this sermon. And so we found out, number one, that selfishness is the breeding ground for unhealthy relationships. Oh my goodness. Onan was selfish. Onan was all about him. He was not about keeping the legacy of his brother going. And so we found him to be a selfish brother. Then we also found out that the Lord had to take him out as well. And so Tamar is left by herself. Had to deal with her father-in-law. Now, she's dealing with her father-in-law. They're going through issues together. But we found out something about this interaction between her father-in-law and her. We found out that the family ought to be the one place where I feel valued. That was our second point. Judah did not make Tamar feel valued, feel a part of that family. And I want to pause and tell you that the family ought to be the place where I feel worth, where I feel connected, where I feel as though I have a voice. And Tamar did not feel that way. As a matter of fact, Judah told her to go back with your own father. And then after a while, we found out that Judah lost his wife. Judah is heading out to a sheep shears convention. And Tamar decides that she is going to get what is rightfully hers. And she comes up with a deceptive plan to get with her father-in-law. And that's what she did. And from that union, two individuals were born. She found herself with twins. Oh my goodness. Tamar is pregnant by her daddy-in-law. And so she has twins now. She's about to have twins. And she's at the point of giving labor to those two twins. And the first twin breaks through. His arm comes through the womb. And the midwife does something special. She ties a yellow ribbon around his arm, which is denoting that you are the firstborn. But you know what happened? That had his arm come through the womb brought his arm back inside of his mama's womb. And the son that was supposed to be the second born came out first. And she said, how did you break through? How did you get through this? And I want to pause and tell you that we learn from this story that grace has a way of turning tragedy into triumph. I don't know what you may be going through. I don't know what you may be enduring. But I want to pause and tell you that grace has a way of bringing out triumph in the midst of tragedy. That's the God that you and I serve. The midwife named that child Perez. And I don't know about you, but Perez, when you look in the Hebrew, it means a breach, a breakthrough. And I want to pause and tell you that you may be like me in need of a breakthrough. I know somebody who can handle your breakthrough, whether it's in your marriage, whether it's on your job, whether it's in your finances, whether it's in your church, whether it's in your spiritual life. I serve a God who specializes in breakthroughs. And I want to challenge you as I'm challenging myself. Lord, help me to keep trusting you, even in the midst of everything that I'm going through. Help me to continue to put my trust in you. And so in closing, I want to challenge you. Let's call on the name of the Lord. Let's trust him, even when we can't trace him. Let's be reminded that if God can do it for Tamar, he can do it for you. And as we close out, I want to remind you that we're spending another week together this coming weekend. I want to invite you to join us as we continue looking at the family. This is all of us.